Hey guys, me Aaron here, back with a brand new video and a brand new episode of album slash EP reaction slash review. This time we're going to be doing Pretty Hate Machine by Nine Inch Nails, and this was a request from my boyfriend, and hope you enjoy. Yeah, he's got some good taste in music. This is his favorite band, and this is actually the second reaction to Nine Inch Nails that I'm doing. So let's get into it. The first song is called Head Like a Hole. Head like a hole. Okay, I'm liking it so far. Ooh, okay. Ooh, okay. That was Head Like a Hole by Nin. Yeah, Nin. And I 100% like this song already. It's very fucking good. Yeah, it was pretty alright, dude. It's pretty alright, dude. Pretty alright. Love it. I really like their sound and the way they use instruments and stuff, you know? Yeah, so 9 out of 10, this next song is called Terrible Lie. The song's pretty chill, to be honest. Despite Trent Reznor screaming like that. Like, that's the vibe I get. So that was Terrible Lie, and yeah, I got some pretty chill vibes from it. It just had this chill tone going for it. And yeah, I really liked that quite a bit. Like, it had a chill vibe, also with some real intensity mixed in there, and it blended well to create perfection. 10 out of 10 song. Next song is called Down In It. Also, the drums sound like they're from the mid-80s. I mean, I guess this album was created in 1989, but I don't know. Whatever. But I liked it though, yeah, for sure. I like it. I fucking love it. I like this dude's voice a lot. So, that was Down In It, and, yeah, once again, pretty much same thing I had to say about the last song, Terrible Lie. Intensity plus this chill-ish shit, but it seemed a little bit less chill here. Still fucking love it. 10 out of 10 song, but, I know this band is, like, a metal band or something, but this album doesn't really seem to fit that genre. It's more of like electronica type stuff, you know? I think later on they became more of an industrial metal band. This is definitely something else though, and it's done pretty well, I think. We got some ads coming up on Spotify, so I'll see you right after those. This next song is called Sanctified. Nice. Okay, maybe I was wrong. Maybe they have always been metal or whatever. But, I mean, there's some guitar in here. There was a couple of guitarists just like a few seconds ago. So, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know, man. Is this about sex or sex and self-hatred? That's what my boyfriend says anyways. That all their sexual songs seem to have an underlying tone of self-hatred in them. So... the song seems to have sort of a bit of a haunting tone to it. I don't know exactly. Like the ambience in the background, I don't know. The soft ambience you're hearing in the background, maybe or may not, is a bit haunting, like a bit spooky, you know? So that was Sanctified, and it was quite alright, I gotta say. But I liked it a little bit less. It was a bit too going on, I don't know. It's a bit too long, it felt like. But it was alright though, like seriously. They did an alright job here. 8.5 out of 10 song. The next song is called Something I Can Never Have. Ooh, I like those piano notes. This is a bit more spooky, I think. Also, this is the longest song on the album. Okay, I like that. That's nice. That's nice. I like that. Haunting. Okay, I like that. I really like the usage of percussion here. It's just like this. Like, just like, it's just that. It's like, and it works. They do good here. They do real good. I'm not sure if I said the title of this song, but it's called Something I Can Never Have. I feel like I didn't. And it's about wanting something you can never have, basically. Yeah. Good song, though. Yeah, for sure. I like this one. Once again. It was just kind of perfect. 11 out of 10 song. This next song is called Kinda I Want To. So that was Kinda I Want To, and Kinda I Want To give this song a solid 8 out of 10. It was an alright song. It was an alright little song, you know. Pretty cool, and to be honest, it was more on the electronic side of things, but with a little bit of guitar thrown in there. So yeah, pretty good. I like it. This next song is called Sin. Here we go. Ooh, okay. This is alright, yeah. So, that was Sin, and that was pretty much full on electronic, and I really, really enjoyed that one quite a bit. Yeah. All it was simply just great. 10 out of 10, this next song is called That's What I Got. Strange sounding, I like it. So, that was That's What I Get by Nine Inch Nails. And it was an alright song. It was alright, yeah. Just alright. Well, fairly, no. It was good, but, 7.8 out of 10. See you right after these ads. This next song is called The Only Time. Okay, that bass though. I like this. I like that. These drums are just real good. That was The Only Time, and that song is just so fucking well done. It's nearly perfect. It's wonderful. It's great. It's truly amazing. I like that song a lot. Probably gonna be one of my favorites on this album, I feel like. 10.5 out of 10. Final song is called Ring Finger. I like this sound. Okay. 80s music just had this great sound to it. And the drums especially. Ooh. So, that was Ring Finger, and, it was an alright song. It was not really my cup of tea, but, I still liked it. In a way, yeah. It was still pretty good. Just liked it a bit less, so, this song gets a solid 7 out of 10, I think. And, now that we got that out of the way, my final rating for the album is gonna be... I think an 6.7 out of 10. Yeah, it was a pretty good album. There were a few songs I liked a bit less, but mostly everything worked pretty well and was still fairly solid. Despite a few songs that could have been a bit better for me, in my opinion. But that's just me. Still a pretty good album. So yeah, that's it for this video. Think, create, most importantly, stay alive, and I'll see you in my next one. Peace out.